Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Pastor Peace. Thank you for this privilege and thank you for teaching me to read. Actually, I learned how to read from Pastor Peace. It was always inspiring me then. So please, accolades to you, sister. And yes, I'm excited to see everybody. Pastor Peter, Sister Princess, and Mrs. Bolade, thank you so much. I'll go right into it because of our time. I'm sorry about my voice. I really tried to preserve the voice for this meeting, but somehow. So please, so let's go into it. Activating the wisdom of momentum, overcoming a reading slump, overcoming a reading slump. We have knowing why it matters. It's not enough that you've participated in this boot camp. What happens after the boot camp? For Christians among us, we know how it is when we go to church and then everywhere is fired up. There's this atmosphere of prayer, and then you get to your house and then you're just there. Nothing is happening. That fire is not there as it was when you were in the midst of people. I'm sure we don't like that kind of situation. So to keep the fire burning, even when the boot camp is not running, you need to know why. So, without wood, the fire goes out. So yeah, your why is the wood. In reading, your why is the wood. Why you are reading is what will keep you at it because okay, if I don't read, there is a lot at stake, basically. I think that's one major thing that will help you overcome a reading slump. So you need to know why. You need to know why. Why? Actually, I've had to listen to the past videos from this boot camp. It has been awesome. I celebrate you, Pastor Peace, again, sir. You kept saying the world is waiting for results. It cannot keep giving explanation. So if you don't have knowledge, what result do you want to give to the world, basically? What result do you want to give to the world? So why matters? Why matters in reading? Why matters? And then reading is an habit that requires a diligent effort. It's not something, we are okay. For me, I started reading in 2017, as Pastor P said. I would say I started living in 2017. So if you knew me before 2017, if I had done anything before then, I usually say that wasn't me because I know I was not aware of my decisions. But I became more aware of myself in 2017, and that was when I started reading. That was when something happened to my mind, basically. So yes, reading is an habit that requires diligent effort. It doesn't mean, okay, over the years I've had reasons. There were weeks that I didn't read. But knowing why I have to read is what brings me back on my feet. I know, okay, I cannot not read because a lot is at stake, basically. I cannot not read. So it requires your effort. And of course, why you participated is because you want to be better, I believe. Why you are here is because you want to be better. And yes, the knowledge you don't have will make a mess of you when life demands it. I tell you the truth. It's going to make a mess of you when you have to explain that this is what happened. When we're expecting you to show results and you're giving us explanation, ha, it should not be heard. So basically, I stated here that you should delight in reading. Delight in reading. Delight is reading because it has a great reward. It has a great reward. Even now, beyond the future, yes, the long-term result is great, but even short-term, you feel there is this light you get when you read. Knowledge is really power. Beyond, I know we hear it all the time from primary school, knowledge is power, knowledge is power. But truly, yes, it is. It is power, and the reward is great. It sets you above your peers. What you don't know, again, it will make a mess of you. In that field that you are in, at your workplace, what you don't know will make a mess of you there. And reading gives you access to a wealth of knowledge, to a lot of people. Okay, for instance, you don't get to meet men like Kenneth Hagin. You don't get to meet men like Watchman Nee, but reading their books will fill your mind. I don't know if you understand me. There's this saying that says you're an average of the five people you surround yourself with. So imagine that you surround yourself with five amazing authors. So you're an average of those hurdles. I celebrate Pastor Peace. We all celebrate him like, oh, his wisdom is not from here, as I often say. But then it's from the place of reading. He reads a lot. That's how he comes. So we're an average of the books we surround ourselves with. So it's important that we read. Praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. Don't mind me. I've been so used to praise the Lord. All right. So yes, this is not church. So yes, you don't have to learn from others from your own experience. You can learn from others' experience. That's another advantage book gives us. We can learn from others' experience. People have gone in that line, that field. You know what? To follow true faith, those that have obtained the promise. So we can always follow these people. We can always read their books. We don't have to make the same mistakes. You know, trial and error can be, it can be frustrating. It can be frustrating when you're making the same mistakes over and over again, when all you just had to do was read. You know, sometimes we pray, we cry over situations that we only need to get knowledge from. The breakthrough we want in some fields is not by praying, it's not by gym. It's just to sit down and think. Sit down and reflect, read and reflect on what you've read, basically. So as we move further, I stated, if you measure the pain, the pain of diligence, the pain in the future for lack of diligence, I bet you will choose the pain of this diligence, no matter how we think is hard. No matter how we think is hard, you know, you don't have to wait till you feel like reading. People used to say, oh, I don't feel like reading. I'm not used to reading. Nobody was born a reader. I mean, no baby was born and the baby started reading. It's an habit you have to intentionally build. I said intentionally because it takes intentionality. You cannot just, okay, me, I did not just want to read, and I believe it's so for some of us here too. You cannot just feel like reading. So don't wait till you feel like reading. That's where the place of diligence comes in. You don't have to wait till you feel like reading. Read anyway. Read anyway. Read anyhow. Okay. So yes, it takes intentionality. So let's go straight into a few things to note. A few things to note towards overcoming a reading slump. It's possible after the boot camp you want to sit back and rest. Oh, I just read six books. Oh, I just read four books. But please don't pay yourself when it's not yet time to be paid. Don't rest. Don't be relaxed. Don't be relaxed. It takes intentionality, as I've always said. And you cannot leave things to chance. If you really want to get ahead in life, if you really want to show the world results, if you really want to show results, you cannot leave things to chance. So it requires your intentionality. Requires your intentionality. You may never feel like reading if you're waiting till when you feel like reading. That feeling may never come. It may never come. We have grown so used to everything around us. The world is busy. Everybody's busy doing nothing. If not for everybody, though. But for most people, they'll say, oh, I'm busy, that's why I can't read. I'm busy. Oh, it's a lie, it's lack of diligence, it's lack of intentionality. If you see reading as something important, you'll make time for it. If you know this thing, my future is at stake. If I don't get this knowledge now, my generation will ask me. Don't give explanation. Okay, I think there's this I just remembered now. There's this video of Haki Apopo. I'm not sure if it was Haki or Popo that asked his father what he was doing when his friends were making money. So why are they poor now? May your children not ask you that kind of question. You know, so it takes intentionality. And another thing to note when overcoming reading slump is to build structures. Build structures that will aid the habit. Build structures that will aid the habit. You know, it's not an habit until it's a routine. It's not a habit until you do it. Everything. And thank God for this boot camp. You've been able to read consistently over the past few weeks. But beyond the boot camp, will you make it a routine? Make it a routine. Don't let your day run you. Run the day. So make it part of your day, basically. Make it part of your day. And don't give excuses for it. It's not enough to make it part of your day. It's not enough to make it a routine and then you're not abiding into it. Don't give excuses. You know, one thing is if you give day you there's another thing for you. If you happen to, okay, you start reading the book and then for some reason you didn't read in a day, there are higher chances that the next day you skip your reading again. And then that's how it builds up. That's just simply how it builds up. So try as much as possible to make it a routine that you do daily. That you do daily before you start making excuses for it, because one excuse will breed more excuses. And trust me, you would it's on you. The excuses will seem legit to you. You feel like, oh, these are plain reasons. I mean, I'm tired. How my brain. You give yourself reasons, but then make sure that you're not giving excuses for your failure. Don't sympathize with your problem. Face it. So build the structure, and then in building the structure, it and I said we should make it a routine, so you can add it to something you do daily. So there's something I did with my sisters here. So we have in NCCF here, we have morning devotions, evening devotions. Our life is church. So one thing I did for us was after devotion, for 1 hour we read. For 1 hour after devotion, we make sure to read, because I discovered that after people go to their PPAs and then they come back and they're like, oh, they are tired, their brain is not working, things like that. Well, okay, oh no. Sleep and all, but then that morning time when your mind is morning time for you, it might be in the evening. For you, it might be in the evening, but it could be after your devotion. After attach it to something that you know you have to do. Okay, maybe after taking, because I know we want to hit, right? So yes, you can make it okay. After taking breakfast, this is what I want to do. I'll read for 30 minutes. Say, okay, 1 hour is too long. It's too much of a stretch for you. 30 minutes after breakfast is workable. 1 hour after devotion, just attach it to something that you know you do every day, and make sure that you don't give an excuse for it. There is no excuse for okay. As the priest said, before breakfast is better. Okay, maybe after eating you feel tired and you feel like, oh, your brain is not working. So that's just on a light note. Just make sure it's something that works for you. If you know, okay, it's after devotion that works for me, it's after prayers. A full belly makes a dull head. Oh no, I'm just hearing this. All right, so please let's know how it works for you and make sure you apply it. Then yes, I stated don't make excuse for your failure. We can give tangible excuses. By the time we think of it ourselves, we feel like, oh, this is a tangible excuse not to read today. Well, think deeper. What is at stake? Your future is at stake. You know, you want to shine your light for the world to see. But if there's no light to shine, what will you shine for the world to see? So yes, do everything it takes to keep your reading culture. Fight distraction. And then the honest truth is that you cannot give what you don't have. You cannot give what you don't have. So even your business, your career, whatever it demands of you, you need to know. And if you don't know, it will make a mess of you, as we started with. So you cannot give what you don't have. So don't make excuses for it. And then yes, another point in not in overcoming a reading slump is determining the kind of books to read. Determining the kind of books to read. You know, sometimes you're not the problem. It's not a matter of laziness. It's the choice of book you made. I've had to read. Okay, Pastor, please can bear me witness. I've read a book one time and I'm like, I start this book. Me, I'm not understanding it. So if you can know how book is meant for you, basically know what you want. Okay, know the area of need that you're facing, and get the book in that line. Know the area of need. So it's not enough to just read anything. Don't just read anything. Don't read story book. Make a good choice of your books. And then in making a good choice of the books you want to read, knowing the author matters too.
Oh.
Knowing the author matters too. And there's one thing I like to make reference to, because even till now it's happening. People will tell you, oh, they are selling books on how to get rich. Is that book that wants to make them rich? They don't have results to show for what they want to teach you. So of course we don't want to learn from those kind of people. Okay, the scripture says, I know this is not church, but it says we should follow through faith those that have obtained, not those that are explaining. Not those that are explaining. So read books that are relevant to your present need. Read books that are relevant to your present need. And then another thing to note is to be in a company of readers. I like that after the boot camp, Utility offers us that opportunity. If you would like to be part of the team, there's this consistency that the team brings to reading 2 books a month will keep you on your feet. So yes, being in a company of readers, your association matters. Not people that will tell you like, oh, this is your reading to yourself. How did they understand? So basically, being in a company of directors. There's a saying that iron sharpens iron. Even with reading, it applies. Iron sharpens iron. So don't be with people that would dim your light. Don't be around people that would give you reasons not to read. Birds of the same feather, they flock together, right? Yes. So look for your kind. Look for your kind and be in their group. Okay, I said Pastor Peace inspired me to be a reader. I would never be able to tell my story without including Pastor Peace, Pastor Sam. All of these people, they were my influence in reading. They were the association I had. Because I know every time I met them, they were sharing one new thing they got from the book they read. And I'm like, oh, wow. Oh, wow. Basically. So be around readers. Be around readers. And lastly, I would like us to know one thing for everybody. Of course, I know you know that by now. In this bootcamp, you can be a great reader too. It's just for some bookworm. It's not for some set of people. We're all meant to be readers, to really excel in life. Sorry. We're all meant to... So it's not just for some yourself who don't make excuses. So know that reading is for you too. It's not just for some people. Yeah, you're a genius. So don't say, oh, he's a bookworm. Like, no, you're a bookworm too. It depends on what you make yourself, of what you make out of yourself, basically. So I'll just charge us again to ensure to give time to reading. Is yes, you're a bookworm too. Give time to reading. And again, as Pastor Peace said, when they are expecting you to give results, may you not give explanation.